awkward when it's quiet. I always thought that part sounded like a fan belt about to go. Oh, it's about to get spooky. The cats don't like this song. Yeah. I have no sketch for this, so I'm just kind of feeling it out as I go. It could be tricky with the ray gun. It's got to be just the right shapes. It's all nonsense, but it's got to look like nonsense that works.
that's creepy.
This is an album that John Mark Pitts and I made together, and this song is based off a shortwave radio recording I picked up 3 or 4 years ago. 9779779. Today we have no idea what that was all about. Seriously creepy though.
Yeah.
officers, they heard that clip at least 1,000 times by now. Still creeps me out. All kinds of hypotheses, most of them not good. Obviously the best one to help me sleep at night would be that it's just someone messing around. When I recorded it, it was close to Halloween, and a lot of people get on shortwave radio and start doing tomfoolery on Halloween. So it's possible, if not likely, that it's someone just messing around, but it worked on me. Really supposed to paint flat like this and lay your whole weight on the painting. I do all the time, of course. Not what you'd call classically trained. Thank you. This is another creepy one. This one's based off a pretty famous shortwave recording called The Lost Cosmonaut. It's a creepy story. I'll tell you about it. So back in the height of the Cold War, during the space race, allegedly, Russia, the Soviet Union, was putting up all these secret missions to space, like manned missions to space. And it's pretty well documented that that's probably true, but one famous one, they allegedly sent a female cosmonaut up, and she immediately started screaming that something was wrong, and she knew something was wrong before the launch, and she started radioing back, saying, abort, abort. And they wouldn't. They told her to keep on going. So when she was up in space, she knew she was dead. She started to burn up, and so she started to curse them. This is where it starts to sound like urban legend. But listen, this is where it starts. Of course, it's in Russian. There's a transcript out there, what she's saying, of course. But it's basically, you've murdered me, you bastards. I'm burning up. I think that's what she's saying there. You're wrong. She says that at some point. I don't know, there's always this thing about the cadence in her voice that made me think, you sound like someone who's dying. Uncomfortable, sure. If you were dying, wouldn't you sound a little more mad? But that's the story. There's a couple of lost cosmonaut stories, and this was a shortwave radio transmission that was overheard and recorded by just some ham radio operator. What in the hey is this? So he recorded it, and once it got out, fades away. Is it bad to be a fan of your own music? That's not something we recorded, though. Anywho, so they're like, what is going on? So the Soviet Union basically responded with, oh, we've been doing these secret or fake secret missions. Like, and that radio broadcast was supposedly just a fake. Which begs the question, if you're going to fake a space trip, that's not a crazy idea, especially at the height of the Cold War, the height of the space race. Why would you fake a disaster? I mean, is there really any reason for that? Is there any kind of logical, we used to do fire drills in high school. Is there any kind of beneficial, drill-wise, is there a benefit to doing something like that? It doesn't make sense. So there's the story, one of the stories of the missing or lost cosmonaut. There's a lot more interesting stuff around that story. You should check it out if it intrigues you. And then get a full transcript of the audio there. And back to RAYGUN. Just kind of all the minute detail at the moment, but this is where it starts to become something. This one's going to have a little more detail and most of my guns. I'm debating keeping it sort of monochromatic in the blues. And this song is called Monkeys to Astro Monkeys, and it's about all the monkeys we shot up into space. The Soviets shot them up into space as well, but of course none of those animals ever came back. That famous dog, what was the dog's name? Oh, I can't remember, the Russian dog. The first doggy in space was a national hero. Everyone applauded the fact that, wow, we have a dog up in space. What they didn't tell you is that poor doggy burnt up on re-entry like all the other animals we sent into space. We just kind of left that grisly part out. Fascinating stuff, the space race. Ruthless. Sputnik. That was such a well-known thing that it was about to launch. Amateur radio enthusiasts recorded it as it flew over. They tracked it and recorded it, and you can go on YouTube and actually find clips of actual Sputnik flying over. This picture being out in your yard on a warm summer's eve, 1957, and knowing that the Ruskies just beat your asses into space with the basketball. Kind of sounds like that going by, actually. A little beep. Too much blue. Thank you. Where I'm at a decision crossroads, keeping it monochrome or adding color. Tricky. I think I'm going to think about it. In time for part two, I will have decided. I know you're on the edge of your seat. Ooh, the lady back there.